As we look at these images, as we think about the extraordinary time in this world, we remember the beautiful line that we are the ones we've been waiting for. And this is the time we've been preparing for. Nobody knows for sure exactly what it truly means, how long it's going to last. But what we do know is we have each other. And so welcome to Saturday Night Live for the Global Peace Drive. This is your chance, our chance to come together in community, where we're going to have music. Walk together, take my hand and we will heal this land. Inspirational speakers.
Recreate, reimagine, renew, relook, respect, and regenerate.
Wisdom jewels.
Let yourself become intolerant of apathy, intolerant of injustice. Let yourself become intolerant of ignorance.
And even some comedy.
With all of this light energy, not only will you be able to heal souls, but I bet you'll be able to re-soul heals.
And some magic.
Are you ready? Here we go. Let's count to three. Everybody, here we go. One, two, three. Solved. Yes.
Recognizing that the greatest magic is how we can all be together, no matter where we are geographically, sharing in the universal language of love and music. With all things, I am one. With all things, I am one. And learning from these extraordinary speakers coming into our show.
We are the imaginal cells connecting right now, and they find a new way of connecting. Well, maybe we're not connecting out on the streets and we're not connecting at big concerts, but we are connecting through the globe right now. There are people all over this world in this moment together, this moment when we are beginning to awaken in the chrysalis to who we are becoming.
Thank you for joining us. The show is just about to begin. With all things, I am one. 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 With all So my name is Scott the Thomas, and I'm one of your hosts. And welcome to our Saturday Night Live for the Global Peace Tribe show. We do want to encourage everybody, please share this on Facebook. You'll find it on my homepage, the Love Coach Academy page, Deborah Giusti's page, and several other pages. And speaking of Deborah Giusti, I am really honored to put the spotlight on Deborah for a minute. She is my partner in this incredible venture. Deborah, thank you so much for all that you do. She does a lot to make this happen every week. So big thank you to Deborah, and I'm turning it over to you.
Thank you, Scott, and welcome everyone to what's going to be another incredible evening. We have such a great group of speakers, some of my favorite people and musicians, and incredible magic and meditation and community connection, which is why we do this. This is such an incredible time, challenging time on the planet for all of us. But when we can come together on a Saturday night and connect, have some fun, have some deep reflection, meditate together, and really love one another and see each other online, it really makes a big difference. We've had so much great feedback and really heartwarming thanks for all of this. So we hope to keep doing this. So please invite people right now to come. I'm going to post our Zoom link shortly in the chat room. So please continue to invite people, put it on Facebook, and also say on chat where you're coming from and who you are, because it's always great to see how many people are coming. And please stick around after the show. We have community connections, and that's where we allow anyone to come on the gallery and share a 1 minute share, heart share of what they want to share with community. So stick around for that. And our intention, Mind Scott intention, is to host this show throughout the lockdown. And that's a big job to do a show every week. It's a little crazy, but with your support, we can continue to do it because there is expenses to produce this and we'd like your support in that. And the way we're going to do this is just like we're doing this in the new paradigm. It's a whole new game now. We are going to use the gifting economy. So we are gifting this show to you right here, right now. And you can decide to gift us back whatever you feel is in your heart. We are in turn going to gift some of that green energy back to organizations that are really important in helping people right now with the coronavirus. And those people will gift their services back to the community. So this is what the gifting economy is. It just keeps rippling forward. And one way we're producing this is by inviting collaboration in. We're going to have a lot of organizations and people come to produce the show and help us. And one person I want to acknowledge that's come on the team is Sean Ahern. He is one of my top partners with Harmony Festival that came in and helped take it to another level, produced all the music, sponsors, and was right by my side, which we produced for 33 years, and Sean did it for the last 12 years. So he's amazing, and he's bringing in music. Also, I want to introduce our main collaborator for the evening, Ken Kaufman of New Living Expo. Ken has been producing New Living Expo since the beginning. It was originally started in 1986 as Whole Life Expo. He continued it, stopped for a little bit, and then came back and is still producing it. And his show was supposed to happen at the beginning of April. It was all set, amazing, ready to go, and he couldn't produce it. And so he decided to come on and help us and bring some of his amazing speakers onto the show for tonight. So he's helping to curate this show and work it through. So I want to invite, and right now, this is New Living Expo that's going to happen now in October. So thank you so much, Ken. And I want to invite you to share some words and let everyone know what they're going to experience during this evening. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Deborah and Scott, for bringing me into this fold 2 weeks ago when I was sitting in the sauna and thinking, what am I going to say? Put me on the spot from the audience after 9:30. And I decided to join this beautiful team to recreate what we're doing tonight and keep it going. I'm going to be facilitating and helping the whole tribe get more and more people to come into this and share their wisdom. Perhaps some of you remember the Whole Life Expo back in the 80s and 90s. I did produce those shows, and it was great. And then in 2002, we started New Living Expo, and that's been going on for now. This would be like our 20th anniversary show. So I'm really happy to bring that good juju for everybody. This particular October, the speakers that we have featured are Marion Williamson, Michael Beckwith, David Wilcock, Kimberly Meredith, John Gray, who you heard tonight, Deborah King, and just added this week, Caroline Casey. Really excited to have her join us. And there'll be more speakers that we'll be adding. And if you want to sign up for our newsletter, you can do that on our website of newlivingexpo.com. And if you want to buy tickets, I have a special offer, and I'll mention this again later on to you, but if anybody wants to buy tickets between now and Monday at noon, I'm offering 20% off across the board of any special event or general admission ticket. Use the code NLE20. I'll post it on the chat room. And then just really thank you for supporting the show over the past 30 years. It's been an amazing journey, and it continues. And we'll just keep it going because the love is there, and we want to and just love everybody up. So thank you. Take it away, Scott.
All right, Sean, you want to introduce your first musical act, please?
Sure. It's great to be here. Thanks, Scott, Deborah, Ken, for bringing me on board, and wanted to help out with a little music here in these challenging times. So I thought no better way to kick it off with the Global Party people, my good friends, coming in live from Australia. I first met them in Thailand, and then we reconnected at Bhakti Fest, where they were rocking for Krishna. And then they played my birthday party at Wisdom LA last year in Los Angeles. I just love these guys' music, message, and what they're all about. It's so good to see you guys. I hope you're okay down in Australia. Their tour broke down because of the pandemic virus. We found them somewhere in Australia. They might be back in America by now, but they're in Australia. It's really great to have them. So let's give it up for the Global Party people who always keep the floor dancing with a good positive message for it. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And so now we have, thank you so much. And now we have one of my favorite people, and I love this woman, Caroline Casey. She is one of a kind. She has a unique art, which is astro, mythological, political guiding, meta storytelling. She has a gift of revealing deep truths in a very entertaining and fascinating way that align with the stars and tell us what's truly going on in the world. And she has a show on KPFA called Visionary Activist that she's been doing for 23 years. So maybe you're familiar with that if you're in the Bay Area. She's the author of Making the Gods Work for You, The Astrological Language of the Psyche. And we invited her over and over again to the Harmony Festival because people loved her so much because she's fun and very funny. And she'll be speaking at New Living Expo, as Ken said, in October 10th. And so I'm so happy to present Caroline Casey.
Whoa. Well, and great segue from the music because Pluto is stationing right now today. Whoa. And again, it's the chthonic earth spirit. So it's good to feel, again, that was a good music quality. You know, in many cultures, there is dancing with demons where the music takes you down and you thump the earth. It's kind of what's going on today. And the dancer artist, all of us takes on the demon dancing and cooks it into. Yeah. So that's part of our dynamic. You know, we are Pluto stationing, death, rebirth. How shall we best cooperate with the big, spooky, unfurling enormity and opportunity of the time, right? So, but first, the evolution of revolution, right? So we used to do power fist, right? Woof, woof, woof. But now we want the power fist to unfurl into the blessing. Hua. So I have some muti here customized from the late ancestor Stella Coyote, actual coyote hair, and some tobacco and cannabis and thing. Anyway, so it's all muti. And so we take this and we go, muti means power in medicine. We invite in power by our words and our gathering like this. Okay. So we go, spirit of liberating trickster residing within each one of us, you know, open the path before each one of us, dance us into place where we can do the most good, have the most fun, and contribute our gifts to the community in a way that is replenishing. Wah, there we go. So also, I have another kind of muti that the South African Sangomas gave to me. This is muti that opens the channels between the living and the dead, between the ancestors. And it's usually used only by Sangomas, but they said, if you meet with good-hearted, dedicated people at a dangerous, beautiful time, you can use this telepathically for them, right? So we go, okay, we need all the help we can get. So astrology is this elegant language I love more and more and more of our interior psyche and its separation by a thin membrane we call identity from the whole big, vast, pulsing creation. Let me bring the whole big sky pattern into play for us now, briefly, a brief tour. There we go. So this is the earth. Here's all of us incarnationally coinciding at this time of dire beauty. How splendid. Increasingly skookum players on the team of creation. Skookum means connected to the spirits and completely competent for the work at hand. It's a really good time for a blessing. That's right. Don't do that. Okay, there we go. Sorry. So first, before we dive full on in, I love that the referee will not start a sumo match until both of the sumo wrestlers are breathing together. And we can just try this for fun, but it also goes with the kingdom of heaven is at hand. We have so much to now practice, right? So this is a mudra, just gently crossed hands like this, you know, sort of pharaonic. And this is a mudra that banishes fear and increases confidence and kindness. You know? So just maybe we do this and just take a few breaths so that we're breathing together, because it's like, whoa, because it's been jumpy. Maybe one more breath. And then, whoa. So, yes, to introduce the players briefly, so it means the collective patterns are in our psyche, right? So as we tell the narrative, so Pluto, death, rebirth, says we've all been granted a customized underworld with which to navigate, you know, in these last times, right? So a friend says panic early to avoid the rush. So many of us are well aware of, you know, how to navigate, dance with demons, make poisonous allies, brew medicine in the underworld in some form. But today, as Pluto stations, meaning it looks like it stood still from the Earth's perspective, and now it's retrograde, it's going to go appear to move backwards all the way until October 4th, back to its rendezvous point where, whoops, my goodness, alrighty, time flies. All right, let me keep going. So this is a big, big, interesting moment. This is kind of like an until now moment. So Pluto stationing is part of the Pluto-Jupiter-Saturn conjunction that many astrologers, and Jim Lewis and I were looking at 2020 and 1981 going, whoa, my goodness, it's the age of Capricorn. And we wondered, what form will the cauldron of death and rebirth take? We wonder. We go, whoo. So part of that dynamic, Pluto likes to cook all of us down to authenticity. And the detective novels from China from 231 BC said, your greatest protection in the underworld is authenticity, that we aspire that our inward selves match our outward selves. And authenticity is related to authority, which contains the word author, you know, authentic. And then authoritarian, when we don't have our own Saturn connection. So we're inhaling all of what the planets represent back into our hara. So the metaphor, we go, metaphors are the incarnational garb whereby power enters the world. And so the metaphor is we've all been granted a giant, huge composting cauldron, the cauldron of collapse, everything pouring into it. And what shall we ladle out? We co-wonder together. And again, Pluto, underworld, roots, soil, mycelium, mushrooms. I love what Paul Stamets says about, you know, science proving folklore, that the psilocybe mushrooms calm down the amygdala, increase cooperation in the regions of the brain, and increase confidence, curiosity, and kindness. And we go, so everything's a microdose. Even just hearing that is like taking it. So we're toasting that. We say the purpose of ritual magic has always been to spiral into group mind, expanded wisdom and tolerance and curiosity and confidence and kindness, that we dedicate at this wild time to be agents of cool response in a hot reactive world. I know that there's so much to say there. We've got the gist of it there because I don't want to run into anybody else's time, but think of what we pour into the cauldron. Everything can be liberating or imprisoning, everything, right? So we throw the old remnants of the Inquisition and all imprisoning language in, and we ladle out that which is liberating at this, again, spooky, wild, powerful time. So I do like, you know, the word endogenous, meaning we have receptors in our being for cannabis. We have receptors also for mythology. So even just this brief speaking and invoking, going Pluto, the cauldron of transformation. And today, I will be brief, but it's spectacular. The sun and Uranus are exactly conjoined in Taurus, dedicated powerful animism. Trickster, be with us. Uranus is nature's evolutionary trickster, experimental genius that loves against all odds. So in closing, there we go. Just the wonderful Amharic blessing, which is Aizan. And it's the powerful blessing that is given, reciprocal blessing for people setting forth on a dangerous but beautiful and necessary journey, that they have all they need. And so we say to each other, Aizan. Mwah.
Aizan, Aizan, Aizan. Thank you so much, Caroline. Thank you very much. Such wonderful information presented in a wonderful way. So now we're going to go all the way to Nashville, Tennessee, which is the home of great music. And some of my favorite music from Nashville is from this wonderful guy. Some of you saw his video that we played to open our show 2 weeks ago. But now we've got him live, Sean Galloway.
Thank you, Scott. Hello, everyone from Nashville, Tennessee. I have a song for you tonight that is about my own personal transformation. And for me, it all started with love. So this is called I Choose Love. Tears, I see a choice, love or fear. So what do you choose? I can see peace, I can see wars, I can see sunshine, I can see a storm. What do you choose? Now I choose to live with freedom flying from my heart where light keeps shining. And I choose to feel the whole world crying for the strength that we can rise above. I choose love. Sharing, or I can see greed, I can see caring, or poverty. So what do you choose? I can see gardens, or I can see bombs, I can see life, or death. Coming home strong. So what do you choose? Now I choose to live with freedom flying from my heart where the light keeps shining. And I choose to feel the whole world crying for the strength that we can rise up. I choose love. I choose dawning as one world united. So what do you choose? Love or fear? Oh, we choose. Now I choose to live with freedom flying from my heart where the light keeps shining. And I choose to feel the whole world crying. And I choose to feel choose to feel us all united in the strength that we can rise above. I choose love. I choose love. And I choose love.
Wow. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Wow. I'm so glad you're with us and you're going to be coming back and doing more with us a little bit later on.
Yes.
And I just want to, a lot of people in the chat box, we have over 450 people with us right now. And the 8 o'clock howling has started outside my window. I don't know if you guys are having that in your neighborhoods. But I'd like to just encourage everybody in the chat box, everybody, all of our attendees, 450 people in the webinar room, put in the chat box, I choose love.
That's just, and then send it to your friends.
And send it to your friends, absolutely. Even my dog agrees.
Yeah, there's all kinds of videos online with that, you know, so, you know, send it to a friend, especially a friend in need. Yeah. That song will pull you out of it, you know?
Yeah, Sean, you can go to YouTube, I Choose Love by Sean Galloway. There's a great video that he's got, beautiful images that go with it. And right now in the chat box, it's just beautiful. People flying all over with I Choose Love.
All right, that's awesome.
Thank you, it's very cool. Thank you, Sean.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
You know, one way that we can choose love is by supporting our community. And this whole program that we're doing that Deborah and I have created, and now with so many wonderful partners coming on board, this all started when we were doing a fundraiser for our friend Fantuzzi, who's got Lyme's disease. And we've raised about $15,000 so far for Fantuzzi. Recently, a lot of us in this community raised over $30,000 for our friend Trevor Miller, who has cancer. And it literally has kept him alive. So we just started a new GoFundMe, kind of connected to this ongoing weekly event, Saturday Night Live for the Global Peace Tribe. And want to really encourage people to donate anything, $5, $10. And some of the money is going to go to people in our local community that need it. This week, we're going to give a significant portion of it to a wonderful organization that makes masks. We'll talk a little bit more about that later on. And we've got some special donation amounts. If you donate $44 or more, I'm going to mention your name online, such as Richard Van Donk, who just donated $77, which got him two free tickets to the New Living Expo. $77, you get two tickets to the expo. For a $99 donation, one of my love coaches, this has been brought to you by Love Coach Academy, and I've got these amazing love coaches that are donating their time, and so $99 or more, and you'll get a free session with the love coach of your choice. Just let us know, $99, let us know how to contact you, your phone number or your email address. And $200 or more, and you can get a free session with myself. So thank you. This is one way that we can show love. And another form of love that I believe is probably the most important form of love is self-love, going inside. And every week we have a wonderful person in our community who leads us into a prayer and a meditation. And I'm really happy that tonight, one of my dearest friends of the world, Heather Salmon, is with us with her beloved Donnie. They're coming all the way from Wailo, Maui.
in a moment, we are going to travel down this path. Oh, let's say 50 years from today, to meet with perhaps our great grandchildren or nieces and nephews, our offspring, the next few generations. So now, as you're ready, I want you to step on that path and we begin to journey. Traveling through space and time ago. From here to 1 year, to two, to three, to 10. Drifting, traveling, flying, floating, you go to 20 years, now 30, 40, and 50. And there you arrive, 50 years from today. 50 years from today. And there to greet you is a small child. And they look up at you, big, beautiful eyes and a big smile. And they say, ancestor, thank you. Thank you for being part of the change. Thank you for your leadership. Thank you for your choices. Thank you for helping and standing up for a new way. And this child takes you by the hand and shows you around this new earth destiny. Showing you how people are living, being, how the earth has regenerated. You take a moment to explore. Looking around the various parts of the planet, how are people living? Who are they being? How are they being? You see the earth green again. You see, notice systems in place that have allowed the skies to be blue and the waters to be clean and the people to be peaceful. And you take another moment to complete here. And that small child looks up at you and hands you a gift. You take this gift from the child. And they perhaps give you any final messages to take back. Words of wisdom. And you complete with that child. And then step back onto your timeline through time and space. You come. You come drifting and traveling, flying, floating, back through space and time. This experience will continue to integrate with you. You've received guidance through your dreams, through nature, through others, through children. And just like a beautiful rose, will continue to unfurl and spread a beautiful essence, paving the path of this new earth destiny when guided by love and truth for who we truly are. With that, you take a breath. In a moment, perhaps a little wiggle, a little stretch coming back into your body. Thank you. Namaste, Ashe.
Thank you so much, Heather and Donnie, coming all the way from the Maui Musical Mansion, the Black Swan Temple. And we'll definitely make sure you pop into the chat box to everybody, how people can reach you. They have beautiful programs once we can travel again to Hawaii.
BlackSwanTemple.org. Thank you.
BlackSwanTemple.org. And definitely, once we can travel again, you want to go visit them in Maui. They do these beautiful personalized retreats. Thank you, Donnie. Thank you, Heather.
Aloha.
Aloha. So for those of you just joining in, because people are still coming in on Facebook and in our webinar room, we have a lot still to come. We've got Wisdom Jewels with Lizzie Tremaine, Trish Wright, and Oshala. We've got John Gray, who's an amazing speaker, and probably many of you know him. Carolyn Mace is coming up. Danny Sheehan is coming up, and more music from Sean Galloway, Global Peace Party, and also from Veer. So there's a lot still ahead of us. We're excited, and I'm now going to turn it back over to a special partner for this episode and partner really in this whole project, Kenny Kaufman.
Thank you, Scott. As we're all in this period of stillness, I want to take that moment and just, it's a huge opportunity for all of us use it as our personal transformation, because this stillness is what we are feeling right now. And with that stillness, I want to take a moment and just recognize Carolyn Mace has been a speaker with Whole Life Expo back in the days and New Living Expo in the last couple of years. Her work is inspirational to all that hear her speak. Carolyn is a leading voice in the field of human consciousness and spirituality. She's a New York Times bestselling author of Anatomy of the Spirit, Energy Anatomy and Sacred Context, and Entering the Castle. She has many other titles as well. She has produced countless material on personal growth and is a pioneer in the medical intuition field. Carolyn tells it like it is, and now I present Carolyn Mace. Thank you.
Thank you for that. Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. And thank you for allowing me to be part of this wonderful evening. I have 5 minutes to talk to you about a subject that I could spend 5 days with you on, transformation. So I've jotted down a few notes that I hope will be useful to you, because you are going through a transformation. We all are. So this is what I wanted to share with you that I hope will make a difference in the weeks and months ahead that we're sharing. First, this is the first time in the history of humanity that the whole planet has come to a standstill. And you can't take your eyes off of that. For all the human reasons they will come up with, you know, it's a bat, it's a plane, it's a bird, whatever they come up with. At the end of the day, really only the divine could stop an entire planet and send everybody to their rooms for periods of reflection, because that's exactly what is taking place. It has given the earth time to rest and given us time to think and to reflect upon how will we proceed with life on this planet. And for the first time, all of us are focused on healing. That has never happened before. And I tell you personally, I don't think a bat can do that. So I think the hand of God's behind this, the hand of the divine, whatever word you want to use. I don't do political correctness. I call it God. So you fill in the blank yourself. But I think this is an act of divine intervention. And for all we know, we were headed down a track toward a nuclear war or something quite horrific or who knows what, and heaven just said, that's enough. That's enough. It's time that transformation truly begin in a way that we deeply, deeply take it seriously. The environment, climate change, how we are living. And as this transformation is unfolding, what's happening is that a deep level of humanity is being born in us again, waking up in us again. We are humbling up, which is where we belong, where we are beginning to appreciate again the smallest acts of humanity and looking deeply, deeply with great gratitude at people who are serving us in grocery stores, knowing that is an act where they're risking their lives to be there to get our groceries. This is transforming us in ways that nothing else could have. Talk about waking up our consciousness, and we need our consciousness woken up deeply, very deeply. We need to break through a shell of narcissism that had us saying, we need our own space and I need this and I need, well, now we have our own space and we can't wait to get out of it. And we can't wait to grab onto each other again and to sit and have a cup of coffee with each other and say, I will never again, ever again, forget how precious a friendship is. I will never again want so much. Now I simply want to appreciate the blessing that is life. This is transformation. And this is what's going on. What's being born is that we are a biospiritual ecology, that all life breathes together, that in healing yourself, you're healing the whole. And this is the inner theology that we now need to really truly get, that we're micro earths and that our biospiritual ecology is one and the same with the whole ecology of nature. So as I close down my 5 minutes, let me just present you with a question that you can reflect upon as a little trigger of transformation that you ask yourself at this time. And it's something to dwell upon in your time of, as we're all here, you know, alone. And that's, you know, what is your most noble vision for yourself? If you think about transformation, transforming yourself, what's your own highest vision for yourself? Never mind this highest potential stuff people talk about and they fantasize about jobs and careers and nonsense. No, 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 no. That's not highest potential. Highest potential is what you is when times are difficult. What's the most you have to give when others are hoarding stuff? How much, what's your breaking point when you think others are saying, I can't take anymore, and you say, uh-uh, I can take a lot more. I can take a lot more. When you say to yourself, I was built for this time. I have prepared my soul for exactly this situation. What's your highest vision of yourself? Because that's what you're going to need now. That is transformation. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much. And I'd like to invite everyone in the chat box, write in, what is your highest potential? Let's all put it in there. What is your highest potential? You know, we are the ones we've been waiting for. And this yes. is the time we've been preparing for. And thank you Bingo. So much for helping us to get in and to drop into that. Thank you. I'm eager to have everybody. It's an affirmation when you've got 430 people reading what you're putting in as your highest potential. That's an affirmation. Thank you so much. And Sean, would you like to introduce the next musical act, please?
Hey, everybody. Hi. Well, inspiring so far. So now it is time for me to go back in time a little bit and introduce Veer McCoy. Oh, I met Veer, I think, at my first Harmony Festival, 2000 or 2001, when we had the Rock and Casbah tent. Veer's been a musical mainstay of life and culture in the Bay Area. Now we're friends down in LA. We both live down here. He can play really anything with strings. Veer can play. I'm so happy to have him here. An accomplished guy, amazing musician, played with some of the greatest artists in the world, also a funny guy and a comedian. So without further ado, Veer McCoy from Hamthalila. Thank you, Veer.
Can't hear him.
Can you hear me, everybody?
We can hear you. You're on.
Well, that was really beautiful, what Carolyn is said. However I'm mispronouncing it. But what she said was basically everybody gets sensitive people.
Toilet paper is far too abrasive. need something softer. I'll try not to waste.
Coming from middle of California, thank you, Veer, for being with us. And we're going to go now to Fort Wayne, Indiana, for our first wisdom jewel from a magnificent, talented lady, someone who's been helping us. It is now time for Lizzie Tremaine.
Hey, guys. I'm Lizzie Tremaine. I'm here at Silver Birch Studios on behalf of Lighthouse Effects. I'm actually going to be singing a song I wrote for you called Harder to Love. So I like that there's kind of a theme going on here tonight. It's called Harder to Love, but it's just kind of clarifying that through this time of transition and through these times of uncertainty, that we keep holding on to hope and faith that things will get better, that we will utilize this time to appreciate people around us, to keep love in our hearts for people around us and for people that we love. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you so much, Lizzie. God bless you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So we are at the midway part of our show. And so we got a lot left, more music, more speakers. And this is also where I want to share with you a little bit more about our vision, what we're doing. And just a reminder to support our GoFundMe campaign. And for this particular show, we're going to be supporting, again, a reminder that you can come in, these special amounts, $44, we're going to mention your name, $77, two free tickets to the New Living Expo, $99, free one-hour coaching session with the love coach of your choice. We've got 14 different coaches, $200 donation, you get an hour with myself. And we also want to show you who we are going to be, who our beneficiary is. And this is, wrong one. Gonna assure you, we have this amazing organization, the North Bay Soists Unite.
That and I can got speak about them, Scott.
Okay, Deborah, take it away.
So what our goal is, as I mentioned before, is we're going to produce this show for you using the gifting economy. So we're giving you this show, and you can give back to us any amount you want. And then we're going to take that green energy and also gift it back to the community. So we're going to be choosing organizations that are really helping this situation that's happening now. And so this week we've chose North Bay Sewists Unite. And this is a group of 700 motivated sewists who are sewing masks for the community. They donate 1,000 masks per week, and they're going first of all to the healthcare workers who have such a shortage and have to use masks all the time, and then other people. We know they've gone to old folks' homes and places like that, and they need money to make the masks, and they are donating their time. So this is a really important cause right now, because masks are part of which will stop the virus from spreading, and especially in our healthcare. So we are going to donate your green energy that comes to us to this organization. And they also need more sewers. So if you feel like you want to help in that way, it's North Bay Sewists Unite. You can contact them and become one of their sewers as well. And each week we're going to come up with a different organization that's really supporting our community, or somewhere we can take the energy, that green energy that you're giving us, and spread it. And then obviously they will help our community. So that's our plan. So please support us and give us some green energy now in the GoFundMe campaign, because it's the power of community that can come together and make a whole different reality. And that's what we did for our friends early on. And that's what we plan to do with this funding campaign that we're doing now. So thank you so much.
And thank you. The donations are already starting to come in. I want to thank Leilani and Ms. Atira and Jessica for their donations. And there's this person named Anonymous who keeps coming in with all these donations. So I really want to send a special thank you to the Anonymous person.
And I want to mention, we're putting the donation link in the chat room. And you can also just go to GoFundMe and type in Global Peace Tribe, and you get right there. So that's how you can get to it, make your donation.
All right. I'm going to turn back over to our partner, Ken, to introduce our next speaker.
Thank you, everybody. And our next special guest, we might have seen him 2 weeks ago, which is great. He's an author, a counselor, and best of all, he's one of my friends. And he's a leading lecturer worldwide on personal transformational relationships. He's the author of Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus, which has sold thousands of books worldwide. He has many more books in the wings. He's always writing a new book. He once told me that he doesn't even need to practice what he talks about in advance, because he has so much knowledge of the product and what he's talking about. If we haven't heard John speak, you are in it for a real treat. He will be speaking at the expo on 10/11/2020 for a 2-hour workshop.
Can you please let him know that we won't have a second set with him, because we can't really do that
anyway again? So here's John.
Hey, so happy to be with you. I thought I would take 5 minutes for those people who are living at home with a partner. So some special techniques to help them get through this time. You know, we talked about, I was so inspired to read the comments of our highest inspiration. So many comments about to love, to bring love into the world, acceptance, appreciations, nurturing. You know, that's what this time is about. I love what Carolyn said about reset. This is a time to come back. It does for many of us, just to feel the fresh air, the clean skies, without all the airplanes and without all the pollution. It's such a beautiful time for many. And for many, it's not. It's a time of tremendous fear and panic and distress. And that stress, if they're together with a partner in their home, can create problems. You know, Wuhan, when they started coming out of the homes, divorce rates went from 12 a week to 300 a week. There's pictures of long lines of people getting divorced, because sometimes spending too much time together can create problems. if we don't take this time to turn inside. That's what's so, it's a blessing for us if we know how to turn inside. I know so many of you listening are meditators. You have your practice, you have your yoga, you have your meditation, you have your spirituality, you have your prayer. I'm just so delighted. I was a monk for 9 years. For me, this is a time of tremendous opportunity to meditate more and do my spiritual practice and pray for the world and feel compassion. So this is like a blessing for many of us, but for some of us in our relationships, it can be very, very challenging. And with every challenge, every crisis, as this is, it can be an opportunity for growth or it can be a danger. So let's make sure that if you're in a relationship, it's an opportunity for growth, to grow in love. So what I have done is created a very special exercise I'm going to share with you. It's based on the idea of men are from Mars, women are from Venus, that men often go to their cave, women often want to talk, connect. And actually, we look at our hormonal balance as men and women. Men, for well-being, need higher levels of testosterone, 10 times more. And often forgetting your problems and going into meditation, letting it all go, is a testosterone rebuilder. And sharing, devotion, connection, loving, that's our estrogen builder, where we interdepend on each other. So what can happen is what happened when, as a writer, I'd be at my computer and my wife would be in the other room with the kids, and she would feel so ignored by me because I was right there in her field, and yet I wasn't interacting her. Because, you know, for single people, for example, they get together and they have such a good time. But then when they're living together, a woman might feel, why is he ignoring me? Well, many partners need to have their alone time to come together. So a relationship is built upon time apart and time together, time apart, time together. And my formula for an ideal relationship is the 80-20 principle, which is 80% time and fulfillment comes outside of the relationship or not dependent on our partners. And 20%, we look to our partners to give more to them and to get more. So my job is to make my partner happier. Her job is to be happy and vice versa. We're responsible to give, but we also have to recognize we ourselves are responsible to open our hearts with love. And we need to fill up through our many activities. So this is a time to turn inside. So I have 1 minute left. This is called Genie in the Bottle Game. And if man and woman, it can be woman and woman, man and man, but it's if you're heterosexual, man and woman, the woman rubs the bottle, genie in a bottle, and out comes the genie. The genie is all powerful, testosterone man. I can do anything. I'm selfless servant. It's like, what are your wishes? And for 20 minutes, you play this game for 20 minutes. She asks for anything she would like him to do within that 20 minutes. And the secret is for her to ask him to do lots of little things and lots of commands. This is, the genie normally gives 3 wishes, but you get a window of as many wishes as possible. And you can't ask for things. There's rules to this game. You can't say, well, clean up the garage tomorrow. Well, that's tomorrow. That's not during the game. So what can he do for you happily? And so she says, oh, I'd like you to go wash those dishes. He said, oh, it's my pleasure. I'd be happy to. What else would you like? Oh, I'd like you to make some orange juice for me from those oranges we got from the grocery store. Oh, such a delight for me to do. Oh, I'd like you to take my shoes off and my socks off and run upstairs and get those oils and give me a foot massage. Oh, I'm so happy to do that. And he immediately responds, because what happens is when a woman can make a request, she feels I'm not alone. It doesn't have to be big either. Actually, the objective is lots of little things. Because what we know is I can give my wife 24 roses. It will create a surge of estrogen, and estrogen lowers stress for women. Or I can give her 1 rose. It'd be the same estrogen. So every act of love scores equal, big or little. So by doing lots of little things, it can create this sense of connection that she so much needs to feel that special attention to her, that intimacy, see into me, respond to me. So this is one fun activity. And you could also do it before going to bed. That would be fun as well. So I hope you enjoy that. And to remember at this time, it's to find the love inside of our hearts to share. It's not a time, if we're not feeling loving, to believe our negative thoughts. Be patient. Come back to the love if the negative thought is there. And I wish you all the very best at this time.
Oh, thank you so much, John. That is like such an incredibly important message for all of us. as a relationship coach, I can say a lot of people are struggling. So let's really remember what John just said and think about what we can do to make life more wonderful for the people around us. And perhaps, who do you know that's maybe alone? There's a lot of people that are alone. So who do you know that's alone? Call them, text them, reach out to people like that as well. Thank you so much, John, for your wisdom. All right, turning it over to Sean, who will remind us of our next musical act.
Hey guys, yeah, thank you so much for getting us this far. It's been a great show. And now we're gonna switch back to Australia. My good friend, Sri and Joaquim. Hey guys, really glad you could join us. They were, on, as I mentioned before, on tour in Australia and pandemic hits, no more tour. So we plug them in here to our online show. So thanks a lot for coming, and Global Party people, take it over.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. And we also want to thank John Gray. We were at a festival with him in Ibiza, and we learned one thing from him. He said, tell the other person, even if you don't agree, I hear you. And it's a way to acknowledge what the person has said without necessarily agreeing with them. But
so thank you, John.
Saved our relationship. He's still alive. So
I hear you. I hear you. But I agree with you too. You're right.
Thank you, John. Amazing. We also want to remind people, sometimes when we're alone or in a family situation, we forget some of the simple things you can do to be happy. And one of the things we do, and it's so simple, is just to sing and dance. So we would love to invite you to go to either YouTube, to our channel, Global Party People, or to our website, Global Party People. And this song that we're going to play is called Govinda Jaya. And we have a Govinda Jaya challenge. So if you sing and dance and you video yourself and send it to us, we're going to make a compilation video with everybody in it. But pajamas are welcome, but just, you know, nothing too risque. Let's lay it down.
Govinda Jaya Jaya.
Jaya, Jaya, Govinda, 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 Ja Radha, 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 Radha.
Thank you so much. And I'm going to pull up, tell us a little bit about how people can get a hold of you. I'm going to pull up your flyer right now. And that's where people can go to find out more about you. Okay. And can you? Okay. There we go. All right. So one more time for the Global Party people. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Start singing and dancing, everybody.
Thank you.
All right. Oshala, please turn on your camera because you're on next. And I want to introduce you. So while we're waiting, I just want to thank all the people that are watching on Facebook. We've got thousands watching on Facebook. We've got about 350 still with us here in the webinar room and thousands watching on Facebook. And there's a lot of wonderful comments, a lot of people who've been really appreciating the show, the music, and it's exciting, you know. And we go back, we try and take a look at as many of the comments as we possibly can. And so anyway, we are now going to go to Northern California. This is my long-term friend, and bringing us a wisdom jewel is Oshala D.
Mute myself, right?
Yep, we hear ya.
Okay, cool. All right, everybody. So I'm gonna just do a little bit of spoken word up in here. Things are so crazy right now. Make me wanna holler, make me wanna scream. But hey, wait a minute. Why do things feel so serene? Birds chirping louder, skies so blue. Traffic, wow, so fewer cars on the road. I imagine Mother Nature shouting out a big thank you for releasing that load. Truth be known, there is something major shifted in the air, and the next wave of 5G is merely a continuation of the for-profit only scare that we have been living with for years. But when have we not been in danger of a tech gone too far? Folks won't rest till they claim all the stars. But there is a limit when the signs say enough. For an industry addicted to raping its own mama, yes, for a buck. For shame, but that has been the game. 500 years, prophecies are now here. But no need to fear, just get clear. With a deep breath, amen. Hotep, Sekhmet, Ashe. All right.
Thank you, Oshala.
I just want to put a little shout out because I know I got like a few more seconds. I want to shout out to all of our farm workers who are growing our food. And I mean, I don't think we can get any more essential than that of growing our food. And also for those whose shelters in place is right under the stars, right? Those who are living on the street and in their cars. All right, everyone. Thank you so much for doing this. Organizers, appreciating it. Giving much love to everyone around the world, to my brothers and sisters all over the planet and in the continent of Africa, which has like slowed down. There's amazing things going on all over. So blessings to you all.
Bless you. Bless you. Thank you so much, Oshala. Hope to see you again here soon. All right. We've got magic coming up. Sean?
Yes, we do. Yay! Magic coming. my great pleasure to introduce Mr. Jeff McBride. I first met him at Burning Man on the Playa years ago, and we've had him at Harmony Festival, and he's one of the world's great, great magicians, a wonderful guy, and really a global philosopher. So I'm just excited to hear what he has to say as what he can throw us with his magic. So without further ado, live from Las Vegas, Jeff McBride.
And
welcome to here in Las Vegas. My name is Jeff McBride, and this is my beautiful and talented partner and wife, Abigail Spinner McBride.
Hi, everybody.
Abigail's going to do a little bit of magic in a moment, but these are for you.
Oh, they're lovely. Thank you. I'm going to set them in some water right now.
All right. Now, I think the world needs magic and the world needs more magicians, and you are out there in this time of unknowing. And magic teaches us three important lessons. The first lesson it teaches us, and we're experiencing it right now, is that reality is subject to change without notice. That all of a sudden things can change in the blink of an eye. And that is true. The second thing magic teaches us is that it's okay to enter the unknown. We don't always have to have all of the answers, and magic reminds us of that. And the third most important thing is that magic reminds us that we are living in a capital M mystery, and that there are mysteries all around us, and we just have to stop and pause and rediscover those mysteries. And we're experiencing that right now. And some things that may seem like simple mysteries aren't so simple at all. A simple deck of cards, to look at it, most people just use them for playing cards. But in Las Vegas, thousands of dollars, millions of dollars are won and lost. Loves come and go on the turn of a single card. That's right. Magic reminds us that there are mysteries all around us, and all we have to do is just reach out and see them. That's right, mysteries that are around us. And one of the things that we like to do is tell stories. And Abigail is an amazing storyteller. She's an excellent vegetarian cook. She's a belly dancer. She sings kirtan. She's a massage therapist. She has so many skills. I call her my Swiss Army wife. She is so skilled. And you're going to tell a story.
I will indeed. You know, one of the things that makes us human is our ability to tell stories. And we humans have been telling stories on this planet since long before the dawn of recorded history. And this is one of our favorites.
For you.
Thank you.
A simple piece of paper. A simple paper heart. In our story, this will represent the love that we share with our family, our friends, and our community.
Our hearts are big enough to hold incredible love and strong enough to endure terrible sadness.
Because sometimes there are moments of happiness and sometimes there are moments of heartbreak.
Sometimes there are moments of pleasure and sometimes moments of pain.
Times when the bonds between us seem broken forever.
We hope that's not so.
We want something more.
The wise teachers all know that the greatest healing power of all is the magic of love.
For the human dream, the universal dream, is a dream of healing, a dream of magic, and a dream of transformation.
Life is returning. Even though this is the darkest hour, no one can hold back the dawn. No, life, life is returning.
Oh,
returning.
Thank you, Abigail. And thank you all for letting us bring a little bit of magic into your lives. Namaste.
Namaste.
Oh, that's fantastic. Thank you so much, Jeff and Abigail. And they have interactive online magic. So hopefully they'll maybe put on, I don't see a website here. So pop
just
into
McBrideMagic.com.
McBrideMagic.com.
That's right. It's a big pleasure to see all of my good friends that are out there tonight, both in the chat room and here in the studio.
Thank you so much. Thanks again. That was great. I just love it. All right. A reminder that when the official show ends, which is around 9:30 or so, maybe a little bit before, then are going to bring in you, members of the audience. Everybody who wants to gets 1 minute to share. And we really want to encourage people to share again today's theme, which is personal transformation in these times. So be prepared for that. Those of you, we've got about 350 people still in our webinar room. Anybody that's watching on Facebook, you can still come on into our webinar room. It can still happen. I'll put the link of how you can register to come on in. So we are now ready for our next song. I am so grateful that Sean Galloway is with us. And Sean, thank you so much for just blessing us with your beautiful spirit, your beautiful music, your beautiful heart. Take it away.
Thank you, Scott. Pleasure to be here. We're gonna pick it up a little bit here. This is called The Source. I hope you enjoy this. You and me, I found a river flowing free like a waterfall, connecting all I see. Some call it God, some call it grace, I call it love, the Creator's face revealing a healing that dreams out in the fields and here in the city, and all that's near is all that bridges space and time. Up from the earth, across the sky, the universe, and you and I is the love between your heart and mine. Every place like a baby's hand, a smiling face, a butterfly, a mountain sky, fountain stream. Reaching within to all I've seen, shouting yes in everything, revealing the healing, the dream. Out in the fields and here in the city, and all that's real is all that bridges space and time. Up from the earth, across the sky, the universe, and you and I is a love between your heart and mine. I found the light in all there is, resting truth on every shore. Living one, I am forevermore.
is all that bridges space and time. Up from the earth, across the sky, the universe in you and I is the love between your heart and
Fantastic, Sean. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. I'm glad you enjoyed that.
And I'm just pulling up. This is some ways that people can get more Sean Galloway. His website is simple, Sean Galloway, that's with A's.com. A virtual tip jar, all sorts of ways. A free I Choose Love course. What's the I Choose Love course?
I'm also a visual artist, and I did a record CD called I Choose Love, and I did a painting to 15 songs, and it basically tells my whole healing journey in music and art. It is especially attuned for people that want to dabble in the arts, and and it's very empowering, very healing, and I guarantee you that you will feel a lot of love when you do this, for sure.
Oh, thank you, Sean. Hopefully you're going to come back and give us more music.
Absolutely.
Show. Thank
you.
I would love to.
Thank you, everyone.
God bless you. Yep. All right. Back to Ken Kaufman. And again, remember, for those of you just coming in on Facebook or on our webinar room, tonight is the New Living Expo night. And Ken, the owner, creator, the man who makes the New Living Expo happen, is who's brought in all of our key speakers. And Ken, would love to hear about who our next speaker is.
You again, Scott. Our next speaker is Sanjay Nimar. He is new to the expo this year. We haven't had him before. He was one of the inventors of the 3G and 4G cellular networks at Motorola. But after years of studying, he changed his focus to become a healer. He spent many years in intense spiritual practices, and he developed many supernatural healing powers. In addition, he has developed an amazing healing technology that transmits healing energy from the Himalayas to any person anywhere on the planet. He'll also be conducting a talk during the weekend of the expo, and I'm happy to introduce Sanjay.
Thank you again for introducing me to this beautiful, beautiful community. By the way, I really loved the magic from Jeff. I totally enjoyed it. So that's my actually topic of the day, is to talk about we can create a much better future using these challenges as a springboard. And I would like to share a few slides with you guys. So give me a second to bring up my slideshow. Here we go. Okay. My apology here for the delay a little bit. Okay, all right. Here we go. Okay. So the power of our thoughts is known to most people, but we don't realize how powerful these thoughts really are. And there's a science behind it. You know, talking about magic, I heard this quote from Jesus when I was 7. Faith the size of a mustard seed can move mountains, and it really fascinated me. Then after many, many years of experimentation, I've started to come to realize that creating a miracle is actually much simpler than we think, and almost anyone can do it with the right tools and techniques. How, you may ask? So the concept really is very simple. So Einstein said everything is made of energy, and energy is a vibration. What is a vibration? Vibration is a sine wave in terms of physics. And a vibration can change matter. A high intensity sound vibration can shatter glass. Similarly, human thought is also a vibration, and quantum physics has now actually proven that our thoughts create a reality. This is not a voodoo anymore. This is not quote unquote untested theories. This is now proven science that our thoughts create a reality. So here is the $1 million question. When we imagine something beautiful, we send out a thought wave saying that, okay, I want this, something good. Why does it not materialize almost instantly? To explain this, let me give you an example. Do you know how a noise-canceling headphone works? This headphone basically listens to the environmental noise and then creates a sine wave that is completely opposite to that noise. And from physics, we know that two sine waves of equal magnitude and frequency, if they're opposite, they will cancel each other out. So the headphone, when it creates an opposite sine wave, it cancels out the noise and we don't hear the noise. Similarly, when you're sending out a thought wave of a belief, let's say, that I want this and I believe it'll happen, and you also send out a thought wave that is of doubt, then the two waves will cancel each other out and the universe will not hear you. Now, what happens if I'm able to, or if anybody is able to, create a belief thought wave that is just a little bit stronger than the doubt thought wave? And I've experimented this for many, many years, that it materializes in the physical world almost instantly. And that's, it's magic. It's literally almost like magic. It is a very, very rapid change in reality. And that matches with what quantum physics is talking about as well. And this is science. This is not, it's like math. It's 2 + 2 = 4, not 5. So if somehow we are able to do this, then we can create a new reality fairly rapidly. Now, the problem is that we are all carrying a lot of wounds from the childhood that also create doubt thought waves that cancel out our desires and needs. And that's where the work is. And we can use the current challenges to clear up our consciousness, clear up our thoughts that as they come up, we clear them up. And then we are more in a position to create something that's new and something better. And I have created a 3-minute meditation that I've worked with many, many people. And in this meditation uses the power of your heart and your will to create the differential in the doubt and the belief. So the belief becomes a little bit stronger than the doubt, and it manifests very, very rapidly. Now, we don't have enough time to go into the details all of that, but I have created a couple of free webinars that you can download from, or you can access from my website. One is to clear your childhood wounds, which is the doubt part. And then one is the meditation to create the positive belief thought through a meditation, a 3-minute meditation. And you can access both of these on my website, sanjaynimar.com/gift. My first name, my last name, .com/gift. And in closing, I would just like to say that we can all create a better future and use this current challenge as a springboard. Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste. Yes, may we all use this. And I'm loving the consistent theme that's coming through both of the Carolyns, from John Ray, from you, about how to really use this time wisely. Thank you so much. We are now coming back to Northern California. And of course, so many of our tribe are here in Northern California. This is a member of our Love Coach Academy. She's a brilliantly talented, multi-talented woman. And this is Trish Wright, who I am putting the spotlight on to bring us another wisdom jewel.
Hey, Trish. Good evening, Global Peace Tribe. I've been really sitting with something the last few days, and I wanted to share some of my thoughts with you. I wrote this for you. In a time where many of us are seeking purpose, and certainty. Our world is transforming, birthing us into a new way of being. Can you hear it? This is an invitation to trust your inherent value, to trust your inner knowing, to trust your inner strength, allowing your essence to be the gift that you offer in the world. Live radically and love yourself. I wanted this evening, and we'll sing it four times. It's really easy. You'll catch on.
Breathe it in, let it out. Breathe it in, let it go. Breathe it in, let it out. Breathe it in, let it go. Breathe it in, let it out. Breathe it in, let it go. Breathe it in, let it out. Breathe it in, let it go.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Trish. Thank you very, very much. That's beautiful. May we all breathe it in. Let it go. We're going to go back to Ken. And I'm not sure, Ken, if you or Robert are going to introduce our next speaker, Danny Sheehan. So I'm going to turn it back over to you.
I'm going to introduce Robert, who's been my assistant program director for probably 20 plus years. And so, Robert, take it away to introduce Danny.
Well, hello, everybody. Can you hear me all right? Are you all right there?
I see you.
Something happened with the audio here. There we go. You all set?
We see you, we hear you, we love you.
You know, Danny Sheehan, wow. He heads the Romero Institute in Northern California. He is a civil libertarian who has had a long case of some of the most remarkable law cases really in American history, including the famed Karen Silkwood case, the Iran-Contra case, certainly the Dakota Pipeline, which resulted in a gigantic win for him and Chase Iron Eyes. More importantly, he is championing the Green New Deal in California to restore our atmosphere. I can't think of anybody better who understands international and domestic policy, but certainly, Danny, more than anything else, I will say definitely, you are certainly America's moral compass. And I'll say that again, you are America's moral compass. Thanks so much, everybody. Please give a warm, wonderful welcome for Mr. Danny Sheehan.
Hi, you guys. Great, thank you. Thank you for giving me these few minutes. I wanna, in the short time that I have, I wanna first identify what I think is the unique nature of the moment that we're in. And secondly, try to explain why I think that the normal, going back to normal, when we get done with this period, isn't going to really solve anything, and why I think even just simply electing Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, or even if he were, for example, to select Elizabeth Warren as his vice president, that that's not going to solve our problems, that we've got to do something much more profound than that, to use this time that we have now. And I want to talk about that, because that the event that we're experiencing right now has really been made dramatically worse by the particular, as we know, administration that we have in place right now, for delaying and pretending nothing was happening and saying that they have to protect the markets by not restricting our economic activity and not really doing the things that were necessary to protect us all. And I wanted to make clear that this particular person, this Donald Trump person, is not the cause of this whole problem. He's the product of a very particular time period that we're in, that we're all going through this extraordinary period of coming to the end of a 75-year Cold War that was going on between the Soviet Union and the United States, and that this is the transitional period that's happening here, where when the end of that Cold War came and the Soviet Union stepped back from this long Cold War, there was this onrush of the people that were the same kind of people that brought us the robber baron era back between 1868 at the end of the American Civil War and 1898 with the ascendancy to power of the McKinley administration, that entire American imperialist era where the United States became this dominant power in the world. What's happening right now is that is on the wane right now, and that there's the rising new Chinese empire of the Asian empire, and that there's a huge struggle going on the part of major corporate capitalist interests to control this and to keep it from happening. And that's what the product is of this administration that's in right now. And they push things right to the very limit where the refusal on their part to deal with the threat of global climate change, which is descending upon us all because of the fossil fuel industry, is really creating this horrendous situation. And we, as Carolyn has pointed out and others, that we've gotten this extraordinary response on the part of our planet now that has generated an event that has ordered us all to sit in our homes and sit down and reflect upon what we're going to do when this is over. This period of from 2 to 4 to even 5 months that we may be doing this, this is an extraordinarily important time, and we have to go back into understanding that we need to sit and breathe and understand the meditative techniques, the readdressing of our proper diets. At this point in time, we're all talking about the same thing here tonight, to make use of this extraordinarily unique time in our history to get out our Zafu pillows, to sit down, to do the meditating. But it's extremely important that we translate this. It's important that more and more of us get into these states of consciousness, as was being pointed out, to set up the wavelengths that are necessary to bring everybody into this harmonic. But we have to translate this into concrete public policy programs. So we need to have a movement that has just not only increasing people doing meditation and addressing proper eating habits and stop eating flesh of animals, et cetera. These are all obvious things we have to do. But what we really need to do is we need to translate that into a movement around the world, similar to the Natural Law Party that was in place in 1992 and tried to move this into the political realm. This is what we have to do. We have to move consciousness and our insights in this new realm of quantum physics and the effect of human intention. We need to direct this into a new political movement in the world to kind of supplant the dominating two parties here in Western culture, the liberal and Republican party, the conservative and liberals. We've got to have a spiritually filled political movement in the world to have concrete public policies that translate our love and our compassion and our affection into economic and political policies. That's what I've come here tonight to talk about in the Romero Institute that I happen to be working with here in Santa Cruz. We're designing the Green New Deal here in California, drafting a 450-page bill to get passed through the state legislature and to set up the Green New Deal in California and also regional and local implementations of that. That's why we need your help. We want you to contact us at theromerointitute.org. Learn what the Green New Deal is all about. Learn what this, how we can translate our new consciousness into concrete public policy programs and help bring this unique moment into the century, the new 21st century, so that we can save our planet from global climate change and save our planet from this kind of sinful, unconscious conduct that we've been engaged in for so many years. The time is now, the people are us, and it's time for us to move now. And I appreciate just the short time I have to talk with you about this tonight. And I love you all. And I send out my warmest embrace to everyone here tonight.
Thank you, Danny, for this sharing tonight and for all your years of work that you've been doing. You've been on the trail, on the front lines for so long, and we appreciate and love you so much. So thank you so much, Danny.
Thank you.
And we have one more very special message that we want to share with you. This message is the Hopi Blue Star Prophecy. This video message was created by Addie Lamborn in sacred collaboration with Earth Guardians. She had a very strong bond with the Hopi.
I am an elder of Hopi tribe.
And she has a relationship with Mother Earth and the Great Spirit by her grandmother. And you can see more inspiring videos on her website. Another piece to the story is that I shared this video on one of my newsletters, Transforming Into the New Paradigm, that goes to 50,000 people. And one person saw it and reached out to Addy and said, we actually need mass for our Hopi tribe here. So Addy called a company in Novato and got a $20,000 donation. And she was able to provide 12,000 mass to the Hopi tribe immediately like that. So I just want to point that out, that that's the power of what we can do now, being virtual, being all together here now and sharing this information. And so this is the Hopi Peace Tribe with her prophecy. Thank you, Scott. You can run that now.
I am a Hopi grandmother. My words come to you at the time of purification, before the great turning. You might remember when the third world ended in a painful deluge, painful to Mother Earth. You made a promise to the Great Spirit to come back and serve the Earth. You promised Mother Earth would never suffer such pain again. And yet her pain became unbearable once again. Once again, your civilizations misused the gift of life. Once again, the human race misused and misunderstood the gift of life force in their own bodies. The fourth world is falling apart. The blue star lit up the skies. The ether is filled with the great purifier. It is not too late to remember your promise to the Great Spirit to prevent another painful end of a world, the fourth world. There is a way to rise into the fifth world without causing pain to Mother Earth. Listen to my words. It is not too late. This is how. First, purify your own heart. This is where your journey begins. Your heart is a receiver of the force of creation. When your heart is pure and open, only then are you able to receive the fullness of life force flowing from the one source. Your heart is also a transmitter. The more you can give. Give pure life force to Mother Earth. Give the energy of love to Mother Nature, to the plants, the animals, the planet, the spirits of nature. You are a receiver and a transmitter of light and love. You also have a great gift of creative imagination. All your dreams of lives are created by you. You are one of zillions of architects of what you call reality. By now, you know there are many dream realities in the cosmic body of creation. Infinite possibilities are available to all. That is one of the purposes of all existence, to discover all that is possible in this cosmic experiment of life. All beings are dreaming their dream realities, not just here on Earth. The cosmos is filled with visible and invisible worlds and their inhabitants. I invite you to pay attention to the highest reality, the Great Spirit and Mother Nature. Activate your fullness by purifying your heart and mind. Use your gifts skillfully and wisely. Only then can you fulfill your promise to serve as an architect of the new earth. The gates of the fifth world are open now. May the Earth Guardians hear this call to add their rainbow light to the planetary grid of magnetic love.
Thank you all. Blessings. And thank you, Addy, for that beautiful message. She does a series of videos, so I invite you to go see her at greentara.guru is her website.
Well, we are very, very close to the end of kind of the official part of the show, but we're going to invite some of our friends to come on up and share a minute. Jessica Robinson, Celestine Starr. And if anyone else wants to come onto the panel, put a note into the chat box and I will find you in the attendees and promote you. And I'm going to turn it back over to tonight's kind of sponsor, the person who invited these wonderful, wonderful speakers, our good friend and partner, Ken Kaufman.
Thank you, everybody. I hope everybody had a wonderful time tonight. I certainly did. I learned a lot. Life is transforming before our eyes. You know, look around. The sky's bluer. The roads are clearer. I mean, life is better. So let's all just take that in and just enjoy it for the time. This is an unprecedented time in all of our lives. We look back on this in 20, 30 years and go, my God, you remember this time? It's like the memories will be just amazing. So just everybody just, you know, do the best you can, love everybody and do what we can to support everybody in this time, because we certainly need it. And I'm offering anybody who buys tickets this weekend through Monday morning, a 20% discount on our tickets for the October 10-10-2020 weekend. It's the code and the Eventbrite link on our website will be NLE20. That's 20% off any special events or general admission. And I welcome you to do that. Also, the New Living Expo is donating 2 3-day tickets, the value is $70, if you donate $77 to the GoFundMe campaign. And also, there's other tiers and plateaus that you can also donate to. So help support the cause. And thank you again for a wonderful evening.
Thank you, Ken. And I'm going to turn over to my partner, the mama of this ever-growing event, Deborah.
And I just want to thank you all for joining. And this is a very organic, creative, explosive event that's happening each week. It's grown to a new level, more people participating. And we really welcome your participation. And what we're planning to do is collaborate with organizations and festivals and groups going forward. Next week, we're planning to have the theme celebrating unity and diversity, because we feel like this is a very important theme for now. The whole world, our whole diverse world needs to come together in unity and really act as one to support this transfiguration that's really happening on the planet now. So we're going to have people of all ages, multi-generational. We're going to have some children speak. We're going to have some 80-year-olds speak and tell us their wisdom, their feelings, what's going on. And we're going to have representatives from a lot of different cultures come and speak. So it's really going to be a wonderful program. We have our spiritual guide is going to be grandmother of the 13 Indigenous grandmothers, Flor de Mayo. So that's going to be really special, as well as many other people that are surprises. And then that's going to be next week, May 2nd. And then May 9th, we're going to co-sponsor with Conscious Life Expo that takes place in LA and bring some of their very top speakers and top entertainers. And then on May 16th, we're going to co-collaborate with the Global Coherence Project in alignment with HeartMath and all that they're doing and many other communities, and possibly Earth Dance Community, which was one of our sister festivals that happened when we produced Harmony Festival. And for me, this is very much like igniting my mothering birthing of Harmony Festival. It's very wonderful to bring back some of the speakers that were there, all the people that were around for 33 years and are still around on the case with this new transformation that's happening now. So thank you so much for joining. Please donate to our GoFundMe so we can continue and grow to distribute the wealth to other places. And thanks for all the people coming to help. If you've got ideas, you can reach me on Facebook, or I'll put my email there if you want to contribute ideas and connection and be part of our team. So thank you so much.
Absolutely. We are building our team. We're building in wonderful ways. This is all organically happening. And I want to acknowledge that Kathleen Gildred, thank you so much for your donation. I want to thank Celestine Starr, Anadea Judith, Deanne Roy actually donated enough to get a free coaching session with one of our love coaches. Thank you, Deanna. That fella, Anonymous, just keeps on donating. We sure appreciate that. And now is the time when we're going to bring on some of you. So if you wanted to share, pop it in the chat box. I'll try and catch it. If I haven't promoted you to panelist, send me another message because sometimes they stream by too fast. Ken, I know that you want to introduce our first person who's going to speak tonight in our community connection time. So I'm going to turn it over to you.
Thank you. Hey, I hear our environmental superhero out there, Resilience, also known as Jessica Jane Robinson. Jessica created the Resilience in a graphic novel series to fight climate change. Jessica can tell us more about you celebrated Digital Earth Day this year and what you're doing with the Berkeley Ecology Center starting tomorrow morning. Tell us a little bit more about that, please.
Sure. Thank you so much for having me on today, this evening. No. So on Earth Day, I participated in StopWaste.org's Virtual Earth Day, where there were youth from all over the Bay Area that participated, teachers, various speakers, and I came on as my superhero alias, Resilience, and I spoke a little bit about how important it is to take care of the planet, and I also debuted my Earth Day song that I released on YouTube on Earth Day, which now has 7,000 views, and so I'm really excited about that. And the song is called Love Letters to the Planet. And tomorrow morning, I am starting my three series class on for the Ecology Center, and it's free. And I'll be expanding on my presentation that I made in the United Nations conference last year. And I'll be talking about why zero waste, climate change, and how to be an influencer of change to help address climate change. So how people can get involved, make a difference, encourage other people to join. And so I'll be going into basically tips of the trade of how I've been able to develop and expand my career over a little over a decade now. And I'm going to, in the chat box, I'm going to share the links of my classes from the Ecology Center, which I said they're free, as well as my Earth Day song, Love Letters to the Planet. So if anybody wants to watch it, I would really appreciate it. And if you can like and subscribe. And the song was made with an award-winning songwriter, Aaron Abelman, and myself. And it's pretty entertaining. It's fun. So please check it out if you have a chance. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much, Jessica. I'm going to put the spotlight, and he didn't know I'm doing this, but Fantasia, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Hey, you know, this all started with our brother Fantuzzi. We did a couple of fundraisers. He played some music.
Yeah.
And look at what you helped get started here, brother.
Oh, my God. You guys have blown me away. Jeff is an old friend. Danny, buddies. Oh, my God. It just keeps getting better. And my prayers are with you. Keep knocking them out, brother and sister.
And Fantuzzi is doing Tuesday nights with Tuesday every Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m. And we're going to be broadcasting it over the same Love Coach Academy webinar network, which we just got restreamed. So now we're going out to more and more people, our YouTube channel, Fantuzzi's channel. So Tuesday night, 7:30 p.m., want all of you to come back, watch Fantuzzi play. And of course, remember to support him and his GoFundMe as well. We love you, Fantuzzi.
Thank you so much, family. I'm getting better and better, and your love is healing. So keep on shining.
All right. And you know what? Kind of makes sense. I'm going to go to Jan Kaplan, because Jan has been a tremendous support system for Fantuzzi and a big friend of our community. And Jan has something she wants to share.
Well, many years ago, I wrote a song and talked about transformations. A lot of people call it the butterfly.
Thomas's thing every Saturday. Oh.
And I'm just going to play you 1 minute of this. You tried to teach me about butterflies.
Thank you so much, Jan. Thank you very much. So a reminder for the people that have just come in, make sure you keep yourselves muted until I call upon you. Celestine Starr, who has been such an important part of our community and led our first global meditation a few weeks ago. Celestine, what do you want to share in your minute with us tonight?
I just want to say I am so inspired. And each week it just keeps growing and growing. And Kenny, you did such a fabulous job of bringing some of our radiant stars. You know, thank you very much, Carolyn Casey. I've been with you since the 80s. So we've been walking this long road and I'm really proud of you to step in with Deborah and Scott. So thank you, just love you. So I came in to bring some really high information from, you know, the heavens. And what I've been looking at when talking to scientists is our sun is weakening its wave pattern. And when it weakens its wave pattern, then the cosmic energies come flowing in. And so we're getting more cosmic energy. And what I'm getting from that is that as it rises, we have more potential as humans to manifest, as Sanjay was talking about, holding in our hearts what it is that we envision. So I'm going to be giving a talk through Aura Yoga Studio on May the 1st. I'd like to invite you all to my Golden Life Wisdom teaching. And the wisdom teaching is going to be, it was given to me by Meso, Keeper of the Books, and it's all about how to manifest. It's beyond the secret. Brings in some really high elements, but also I wanted to share about our resonant, our Schumann resonance wave pattern, which is normally at 7.83. And just imagine that it's now at 60, 70, 110. How is that affecting you? So I just honor all of the light workers, all the people who have been holding the light the whole way through. This time, you know, we have the brothers of reverse consciousness and then the unified field. I want to love you all because you are the awakened hope for humanity. And so thank you. Some people say we all come from the stars and to the stars we are returning. Some people say it's time to go. To go from earth to the beyond, to go from earth to the beyond. So dream big, know that we are held by the luminous ones. We are those that we've been waiting for. I love you all. Blessings, blessings. Thank you, Scott and Deborah, for letting me speak these little 1 minute pieces. Love you so much. Thank you.
Hi, it's Connie Baxter Marlowe and Andrew Cameron Bailey. We're authors of The Trust Frequency, 10 Assumptions for a New Paradigm. And what we want to say is that the Earth is shifting into a higher frequency and we have to do our own work to keep up with her. Like, just like Sanjay said, we have to go inside and heal those wounds and bring our frequency up, do our work so that we can join the earth as she moves into this higher frequency and we can bring heaven to earth, peace on earth. We just have to choose it. We have to vibrate there and it's all physics and it's all love and wonderful program. And thank you so much. It's so great to be here with the tribe. So many longtime friends are here, and thanks for bringing us on, Scott.
It's our pleasure. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you, Scott.
Yeah, I've known you two a long time. Leilani, I want to go to you, but if you could work on getting a little bit better lit, it's a little bit hard to see you. So we're going to go to Ruby and then Deborah Haviland and then Leilani. If you could work on your lighting, that'd be great. Ruby, you're up.
Hello, hello. Wow, Scott. Thank you so much for doing this with Deborah and with Kenny. Scott, how many years it's been? I was trying to remember when the last time I saw you.
It's been a long time. It's good to see you again, Ruby. Wonderful to see you.
Yeah, I so appreciate what you're doing for the community. And I love this theme tonight, you know, personal transformation during these times, you know. So personally, the first couple weeks, it was kind of like, wow, very, very discombobulating. Because things were accelerating so fast, you know, all the emotions coming up. And now what I really, really appreciate is, wow, the accelerated transformation. So I feel like literally like transformation has been up 100 times, you know? So what would it taken me 100 years to clear? I feel like it's happening now in a day or a week. And one of the things that I wanna bring up today, and thank you so much for this opportunity to share it, is about the Stargate behind me. Because their work has been amazing. They have been having daily for the last month, like 1,000 people coming online every day for the last month, meditating together. So I actually would inspire for everybody to kind of look at this. Isn't this a beautiful thing? This geometric, sacred geometric structure. Actually, this is something which Deborah and Celestine are very familiar with. And the last thing I just want to mention is that, you know, this has all been a gift that they have been providing community. And now they're actually offering a 4-day meditation, which is called Accelerating the Awakening of Humanity. And it's totally free. And the amazing thing is they have over 10,000 people signed up already for it from all around the globe. So I would just like an opportunity to invite the community here. To be able to enjoy this and really join this part of the community that has just been building and building and building over the last month. So if I may, I'd like to just put the link in it.
Sure. Put the link in the chat box so we can all learn more about it. Thank you, Ruby.
Yeah. Again, thank you so much for the opportunity. And that is one thing I'm just so grateful. I just feel like that is what has helped me to elevate my energy and to be able to stay in the high vibration, to go through all this transmutation and all the gifts of this accelerated transformation right now. So thanks again, Kenny and Deborah and Scott, for all that you're doing for us.
Pleasure. All right, we're gonna turn over to Deborah Haviland, who I believe wants to read a Rumi poem for us.
Yes, and I do wanna just thank everybody, this amazing community. And as I was just turning it over to God and saying, okay, God, what would you like me to say in addition to this short poem? So much gratitude. And I keep seeing Mount Shasta and all the ascended masters and the angelic realms and all the ways that we've all been hooking up to the ascension codes and waking up and clearing veils and veils of whatever that we need to clear so that we can be the love, be the forgiveness. And so this poem, you know, there's so many things I'd like to say. I wish I had time to read this Aramaic poem or channel, but I'm gonna, since we have a minute, I'm gonna do this. And I, you mentioned just this, the global feeling of I lead Awaken the Soul retreats, and I do it wherever I go. I did it on Mount Shasta in the 80s and Maui in the 90s and now in Costa Rica and different places that I'm guided to go. So everything, may we be guided to do our highest work day by day. So this is a Rumi poem that actually I choreographed a dance to when I lived in Maui in the 90s. And it's, come to me, I'm your lover. Come to my side. I will open the gate of your love. Come settle with me. Let us be neighbors to the stars. You have been hiding so long. aimlessly drifting in the sea of my love. Even so, you have always been connected to me, concealed, revealed, in the known, in the unmanifest. I am life itself. You have been a prisoner of a small pond. I am the ocean and its turbulent flood. Come merge with me. Leave this world of ignorance. Be with me. I will open the gate to your love. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Deborah.
I love Coach Scott, and I love Scott's teachings and the Love Coach Academy. It's brilliant what's happening with the Love Coach Academy. Thank you.
Thank you, Deborah. Thank you so much. And thank you, Leilani, for giving us more light so we can see you more clearly. You're up.
Hello, everybody. And thank you so much, Scott, Deborah, and Kenny, for your love. And this time is just so, I'm so appreciative. It's just such a hard time, and it's so wonderful to connect. And it's one great thing about this crazy time is that it's an opportunity, and you're all so inspiring. And this is such a great evening and such a great show and so fun and so comforting to get together like this. And I just wanted to come on and just share a little tiny little song that I created while walking up a hill, a very steep hill, because where I live in Vilcabamba, Ecuador, it's a lot of mountains in the Andes. And it was just all happening. And so it's just a little song about our raising our vibration and a prayer to spirit to help us through this time. So I'll sing it now. Hey, great spirit, listen to our prayers and heal all suffering. Hey, great spirit, listen to our prayers and heal all suffering. Calling in the angels of love and light, gonna heal one another, gonna feel all right. Raising our vibration to our highest frequencies, turning from a caterpillar to an eagle in flight. Thank you all, and just, it's all we can do is love as much as we can to heal the fear and the suffering. Many blessings to all, and thank you for coming together.
Thank you so much. Ken, you've accidentally started a screen share, so we need you to stop that, please. I'll have to go on and kill it. There we go. I hate having to do that. All right, we're wrapping up. If anybody else, Christy Michaels, okay. Anybody else send me a chat if you wanted to come on, because we're about to conclude. Here's Christy Michaels. You're on, hi. Christy.
Yep. Deborah and Scott, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. What an awesome journey you've led us all on. And tonight was such an incredible message. And I would just like to implore everyone to share this and on Facebook and get the message out, because I think this should go viral. I mean, there were so many powerful things that were said. I loved what Carolyn Mee said, that can't wait to hug each other. So I give you my love. I send you my love and blessings to everyone. Thank you so much, Scott and Deborah, for all your hard work, because I know you're doing a lot of hard work to make this happen. Thank you. Blessings.
You're welcome. And it's true. I want to really acknowledge a lot goes into doing these shows.
Yes.
Like 20, 30 hours a week for both Deborah and myself. So
I know.
Thank you for your appreciation.
The best.
And, I again really want to acknowledge that we've got this GoFundMe campaign, and we really ask people, thank you so much for the people that have been donating. Just please do keep those donations coming in. I'm I'm not clear, Kitty, if you were wanting to share. I'm not clear if Adrienne is wanting to share. So if one of you are wanting to share, please turn your camera on, unmute yourself, and say something so I know.
Good evening. Good evening, and thank you all. This is, I'm so glad that so many free things going on, and I've just been my head spinning and trying to absorb everything. And I'm so glad that tonight I am here. Thank you. I've been slowed down for the last decade, and the world is finally catching up with me. That's how I'm starting to see the world. And this song has been in my head. A friend wrote it years ago. I'm just so glad that I can finally share. Earth, she is our mother. We will never have another suicide treating her this way. Spacious skies are dying, seas they ain't a shining. We tainted all the amber ways of grain. Must come out from our denial, eyes open for survival. For the purple on the mountain ain't so majesty. No, the purple on the mountain ain't so majesty at all. Can we get some musicians playing there? America, America, we sure have shamed on thee. We clouded all your clear blue skies, we poisoned all your seas. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. The earth is sad, open your eyes. It's up to you, it's not too late. We can make this world such a beautiful place. If we just stop treating mama this way, open your heart, open your mind, let your spirit soar, let your spirit soar, open your heart. Open your mind. Mantuzzi, that's something we got to work on one day. Many blessings. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, I believe Leah wants to say a little something. You need to unmute.
One more time. So say hi, tribe. Hi, everybody. Thanks, Deborah and Scott and Ken. What a great, great evening, really. So I told Scott I was messaging him privately. I'll keep this really short for me. What I was posting earlier this week on Facebook was this. You know, for me, it's not about the fear of this virus. And it's important to have fear, I guess, in certain cases. But for me, my fear is one or coming back from this whole thing and being the same person, not really surrendering into the transformation, what's really happening to all of us. And all our different levels and all of our different backgrounds and what has brought us to this now moment. So that's really the thing I'm offering tonight is, will you come back as the same person? You know, is that good enough? Or are you allowing yourself to surrender into the true transformation of the real evolution that may be going on within? So that's really it.
Wow.
Namaste, I mean, everyone.
Thank you very much, Leah. Thank you, first of all, being short and sweet. Kind of going to gallery view so we can see everybody that's still with us. And yeah, I mean, that's Brené Brown wrote something really beautiful about not going back to normal, because normal wasn't working. Normal was not healthy. Normal was not a good thing. And so, yeah, it's not about going back to normal. It's about during this time of reflection, really getting clear, what do I need to change in my life? What do I need to change in my world? All right. I'm going to turn it over to close this out to my partner, Deborah Giusti. You're up, Deborah.
Yeah, I just want to say it's so great to see you all. And it just ignites this mama bear in me and this history that so many of us have together of just being on this mission and in this love vibe and in this community connection for so long. And All right, there we are. So I am here to share my love with you. And when I see all your faces and everyone coming on, I just am so amazed at how this, as a soul tribe, we are here together. And we've been showing up for a long, long time. And all of you, I look at the gallery and you're all so special and you're all doing your own divine mission. And we're all being called to next level. And that's why we're showing up on this virtual play party here and sharing our love. And I just want to just share my heart and share my love and know that I'm here in service, as you guys know, because that's what I'm about. And just share my love for my kitty, Queen Sheba. Mwah.
Beautiful. Yeah, both my dogs, both my pups are right down here, but I'm not going to take the camera and show it, but they're down there. All right, everybody. Well, thank you. It's amazing. We still have 170 people in the webinar room watching us. So that's kind of cool. And God knows I'm on Facebook.
So and I want to get. I want to thank everyone for the donations, because we did get some donations in, and really we're going to pass that on and use it to create even better shows for you. So really, really appreciate it. It does make a big, big difference. So I wanted to make sure I said that. So thank you.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Deborah Haviland, who just donated. All right. So again, thank you to all of our speakers, our wisdom keepers. Sean Galloway, I love your music. Oshala, so good to have you join us and bless us. Jeff McBride's magic blew me away.
Ah.
God, that was fun. The global party people all the way down in Australia, they're still watching. Thank you so much for your music. And of course, Ken Kaufman and his right-hand man, Robert Perala. Thank you for everything you guys do with New Living Expo. And most of all, thank you, Deborah, for making this happen.
Thanks,
we'll look
Scott.
Forward.
We'll keep it going. We'll keep it going for weeks on end.
Absolutely.
Even more exciting.
And remember, New Living, the New Living Expo is happening in October. So we're excited about that. And also a reminder that my company, Love Coach Academy, provides free webinars every day, 9 o'clock in the morning, 6 o'clock in the evening, Pacific time. And we've got all of our different love coaches doing great shows. Thursday mornings, it's on self-love. Friday evenings, recovery talk. And every day we have a special theme. So check it out. You'll find it at lovecoachacademy.com. That's where you'll see what we're doing, find our schedule, see our shows. So we'll see you through the week on lovecoachacademy.com. Join us for Fantuzzi on Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m. And of course, we'll see all of you back here next Saturday night for our unity and diversity show, with people of all ages and races and backgrounds sharing their wisdom and sharing their music and maybe a little magic.
One last thing is keep sharing your ideas and your thoughts and tell us who you want to have on the programs. We need your feedback. Thank you. We did a survey.
It's really true.
Did a survey and you can, you know, I don't know how 100 people sent it in. I don't know, 200 people, but we just did a survey.
And yeah. And we'll probably adjust the survey and send out another one again to all of you. So fill out the survey, because that helps us to know what themes you want, what people you want to see, more of this, less of that. Anything but less of Scott. That's not an option. No, seriously. Thank you, everybody. Thanks, Ken. Thanks, Deborah. God blessings.
Bye-bye.
I'm going to go get some dinner. Good night, everybody.